I'm so excited for today's video. Today's video, I'm finally discussing and talking about Saxon Math. I have had lots of you ask for a video review on Saxon, and here it is. So we switched to Saxon Math early into this school year for my fourth grader. We were using The Good and the Beautiful. It was not working for my fourth grader, and so after just doing some research, I decided to switch her to Saxon Math, and we absolutely love it. So I've said that 100 times in videos, but I have yet to share reviews. So today I'm going to be talking about Math 5-4 from Saxon and using Nicole the Math Lady. Now here's a full disclosure. The Saxon program, which specifically written by Saxon himself, starts at 5-4. It's these like, yellow books, the 5-4. Now, there are other companies or people, from what I understand, that he's worked with, and so there's different editions or different types, or like the Math 1, 2, 3. Those are not the Saxon Math method, and they were not written by him. So there's other videos on that you can research yourself and review. So I'm specifically in this video talking about Math 5-4. This is the true Saxon method of teaching math. One of the main reasons we switched to it is my fourth grader is just very to the point. She was getting distracted and discouraged from all the fluff, I like to refer to it, in The Good and the Beautiful. And she just wasn't really retaining the lessons. And so I needed to find something that is more black and white, and no pun intended, Saxon is black and white. There is nothing beautiful about these textbooks. One thing that was also very important to me was video lessons. I was already used to using The Good and the Beautiful, where they, in level 4, they teach the lessons. Now, I was always having to step in and reteach the lessons, so I don't know how great those videos were, because honestly, I wasn't paying too much attention to them, but I knew I wanted some sort of video lesson, because right now I'm doing okay teaching math to them, but I know as they get older, I'm gonna need more. So kind of having what I wanted in a curriculum, what led me down the path to Saxon and Nicole the Math Lady. So they're two separate things. You can just do Saxon. And so if you were to buy Saxon 5-4, you would get these three books. Now, what does 5-4 mean? 5-4 means when you look at Saxon Math, the second number is the on grade level number. The number in the front is, so if your kid's in fifth grade but maybe is struggling with math, you would want them to use this book. So it's for maybe a fifth grader that needs a little bit more review, or you're switching from a different curriculum, this would be good for a fifth grader. Or if you have a fourth grader who can handle it, they're on a good track, then this would be for just a little, you know, explanation of the two numbers. It doesn't mean fifth grade. I guess it does. Well, there you go. So that's what the numbers mean on their curriculum. So what you would get is you get the actual student workbook. So this big one is like the most important one. This is all of the lessons and all of the reviews. So there are 120 lessons, but there are also tests and there are things called investigation. There are 12 investigations, and those are just a lesson in a different way. And I feel like they do take longer than the traditional lesson. So there's 12 of those. So 120 plus 12, plus you have a test booklet, and there are 23 tests. So do not be deceived with 120 lessons. This is closer to, I say 160, but like around 155, I think. So that is something to take into consideration with planning. If you're used to 120-day lessons and that's it, that includes tests and everything, that's not what's going to be happening. So that was something that I had to get used to, because it's going to take them a little bit longer in the school year to get done with it. So book one, lessons and review. So this is like the main book for your students. This is the tests and worksheet. So obviously the tests, I think there's one test like every 5 lessons, maybe 5 or 10 lessons. I can't remember, to be honest. And then there's practice sheets. So there's a lot of like addition practice, multiplication, just like kind of just like quick review facts that they're supposed to be able to do pretty quickly. Those are randomly throughout the lessons. And then there is the solutions manual. So this is all the answers for you or whoever would be grading the work. What I really like about the solutions manual, just to kind of show you, it doesn't walk you through like step by step, word for word, how to solve the problem, but it shows you how they should have solved the problem, if that makes sense. So we'll say number 20 for dividing. It tells you like how it should have been broken down in their work. So I really like that because I can compare it to her work and be like, okay, what are you doing wrong in this? To be honest though, I rarely pick up the solutions manual. I'm still able to pretty much help her if she needs assistance with any of the problems that she's getting wrong, because we also use Nicole the Math Lady for grading, and I'll talk about that in just a minute. All right, so three huge books. It seems crazy. It seems like a lot, and I'm telling you, it took me so long to make the leap because I just kind of felt a little overwhelmed and I'm like, oh my gosh, that's so much stuff. I don't understand. What are all these books? But honestly, we could probably get away with just having the student book and the test book because, like I said, I don't really use the solutions book at all. Now, when she's in the older ones, yeah, I'll probably need a little bit of extra help with those. But that's just kind of my opinion. These are the three main books. She's in this main one every day. And how it works is you go to the lesson for the day, and the lesson of the day is going to teach you a concept. This could be a new concept, or it could be a little bit more in depth on a concept you've already learned. Saxon is a spiral approach. So they are constantly reviewing things all the time. And I absolutely love that. I think that is so important in math because, yes, I learned how to multiply fractions 3 years ago, and now I'm seeing it on a test and I can't remember. Just because it's not that I don't think kids could do it once they're reminded, but just having that constant practice randomly, it keeps them on their toes. They don't know what to expect in the review, and it makes them really solidify their math knowledge as it keeps growing as well. So I like that method. I like the spiral approach. The Good and the Beautiful was the same way, and that was something I appreciated about it. So how a lesson works, she opens up her book. Here's lesson one. There's a warm-up, so it can be mental math. It can be one of those fast, quick math memorization papers. And then there'll be your new concept. So that's the actual lesson. Now in this book, it teaches you the lesson. So you have quite a few options. You could teach it to them. They can do it independently. They're at an age, I think, level wise where they could do this independently, but it's all there. So either you as the parent, the child can do it on their own, or you can use Nicole the Math Lady, which is what I do, and I'll show you in a minute. They have specific lesson practice. So this is always random, so see lesson practice. These are problems specific to the new concept that was taught. Sometimes it's 10 questions, sometimes it's 2 questions. It really depends on the concept. But most of the time between the lesson itself, and we use Nicole the Math Lady, so we're watching a video lesson, the lesson itself is normally between, we'll say, 10 to 15 minutes. And then the lesson practice normally takes my daughter another 15 minutes. So that is 30 minutes doing the lesson and the lesson practice. Then there is always the mixed practice. This is anywhere from 20 to 30 problems, depending on what types of problems they are. And this is done every lesson. So this is their review. This is going over previous taught concepts, ensuring that they're practicing and they know how to solve those problems. Now, the older you get in math, the more complex the problems are, the more steps it takes to solve them. So we choose not to do every mixed review problem. So what we did, because I heard somebody say it, we only do half, and how we do it to where I think it kind of is fair. If the date is an odd date, so if it's the 15th of the month, then we do all the odd problems. If it's the 14th of the month, then we do all the even problems. So by rotating it like that, because they give you like 4 of the same problem, we're not missing any concepts that need to be reviewed. By doing it this way, my daughter normally gets it done in around 30 minutes, sometimes 45 if it's a concept that she's maybe struggling with a little bit. So overall, she spends between an hour to an hour and 15 minutes on math. Sometimes shorter. It honestly depends. It depends on the mood. It depends on the concept she's learning. Some concepts she's done in 5 minutes, and I'm like, all right. Others, like I said, it takes a little bit for her to get through. So what has worked for us is only doing half of the review problems, and she's taken all of her tests, and she's gotten consistently high grades on all of her tests by only doing half of the mixed review problem. All right, so now, so those are lessons. So then every, I think, 10 lessons, there's something called an investigation. This is just a little bit different of a lesson. There's a little bit more thought that goes into it, investigation. There's a lot more reading involved. Like this one is about centimeters and kilometers, measuring. So, I mean, it's still a lesson. I honestly haven't figured out why they're so different than normal lessons, but we treat them just like a normal lesson. So she does the lesson. The only difference is I don't know if Nicole the Math Lady actually teaches the investigations. I think it's more independent for your kid to work through. So they've been fine. We just treat them as like a normal lesson. And then I should mention too, we don't do these activity sheets. These, I don't know. They're like addition, subtraction facts. She doesn't need practice on those, so we don't complete these. So that would probably add another 10 minutes to your school day if you did do those. Just throwing that out there. Okay, so let's move on to tests. So tests are normally around 20 questions. They're normally only one page. And again, they're a review of the last, like, I think five concepts that are taught plus just a general review. So we're doing those, I think it's either every 5 or every 10 lessons she has a test, and same thing, we just treat those as like her lesson, and that's what we do. Now, my favorite part of why we love Saxon is Nicole the Math Lady. I have heard about her, and everything you hear is true because it's all positive, and she is just an engaging, extremely intelligent lady teaching these Saxon math lessons. So what is Nicole the Math Lady? It's an online website where you create an account, and there is a subscription that you pay for, and you get access to all the lessons. So like I said, my daughter opens up her math book, she opens up lesson 70, and she goes onto Nicole the Math Lady's website, goes to lesson 70, and Nicole teaches the lesson to her. That's one part of Nicole the Math Lady. The other part, which is an additional part, you don't have to use it or buy it in your subscription, is the grading. So when my daughter does her lesson, she does her work in her workbook, and then she enters her answers in Nicole the Math Lady's like system. As she's entering it, it's giving her immediate feedback if it's correct or incorrect right away. So my daughter has learned, one, she gets instant gratification, right? If she's getting the problem right, it boosts her confidence right then and there. And that is something that encourages her, and I think she really enjoys about this curriculum, is she's getting that instant feedback, as well as if there's a problem wrong, she knows right then and there, she doesn't have to wait for me to grade it. I don't have to go back through the lesson and figure it out, and now it's 20 minutes after she did it and she doesn't even remember why she did it that way. It's instantly done. She can either check her work, because it also does in the lessons, like so for multiplication and division, it teaches them how to like reverse it and check their work. And so she's gotten really good at, one, showing her work on her problems, checking her answers, because it's almost like a competition, right? She wants to get a good grade, because then it does grade it. And so she doesn't want to get them wrong. She wants to get them correct. And so it's slowing her down. She's double checking. So that is something that I really like, as well as I can track all her records and grades for math. I can see if she's getting the same type of problem wrong all the time. There are a bunch of settings in Nicole the Math Lady where you can give them multiple chances. So on the lessons themselves, like the daily practice, I give her 3 chances to correct it and get it right, because those, she's just learning it, whatever. The test, she has one chance. So her test scores are her true test scores. There's no option to try and get a better score because they're tests. It's, you know, and I'm not trying to be mean or make my kid like afraid of tests, but it is what it is. There's one answer in math. You either get it right or you get it wrong. And so it's been working great. And my daughter, who can be a little unmotivated with something like math, like actually has not complained at all since we switched to math. And it's not that it's going quicker than the Good and the Beautiful or it's easier or anything like that. It's just she likes the format. She likes Nicole the Math Lady. She likes the black and whiteness of the lessons, and she likes that the way it's all set up. I forgot to tell you, I think my favorite part, and this isn't even Nicole the Math Lady. This is just how Saxon is. Okay, so here's a mixed review example. So let's look at number 14. So do you see right under number 14, it has 68? So if she gets number 14 wrong, if she looks at that little 68, that tells you what lesson that concept was taught in. So if I don't know what that answer is or she doesn't know, we can go back to that lesson and it tells us how it was taught. 99.99% of the time when she goes back to that lesson, she can solve the problem on her own. So that is my favorite part. I can't believe I didn't even mention that in the beginning. That is probably a little bit higher than Nicole the Math Lady because that helps me to help her resolve it. So that's what I was kind of saying. I don't really need the solutions book because I'm not trying to figure it out. I want her to figure it out, and I just kind of want to help her figure it out. So we go back to the lesson. The lessons aren't long. We read through it, and we're like, oh, yeah, sometimes it's just like, oh, I forgot that. And then she knows how to solve it. So that is probably my favorite thing, is understanding, where was I taught that? How do I know how to do that? Because they're not trying to trick you. They want you to succeed. And that's how this curriculum is set up. So that is, I think, all I can share about Saxon Math, besides we just absolutely love it. I do have an affiliate link with Nicole the Math Lady. As I'm filming this exact moment, I can't remember if there's a discount, but I'll link it down below. There is a free trial. So before I even bought all the workbooks from Saxon, I did actually buy these ones used off Facebook Marketplace. I had some friends send me some images of the workbook so I can kind of see what the lessons were like. You can get a free trial with Nicole the Math Lady to see how she's taught. See if your kids are engaged by her, if you think that's something that would work. So I'll link that down below. And the only other thing I'm going to say is I already bought 6-5 for her fifth grade year. And I did buy Saxon 3 for my second grader going into third grade. So like I said in the beginning, that's not the same methodology and writer as these ones. But I've heard wonderful things about Saxon 3. And so I figured I might as well just get her started. I hope you guys like this video. If you have questions on Saxon, leave them down below. I would love to answer them. But that is the end of this video. Have a wonderful day, guys. We'll chat soon. Bye.